In this video, let us learn about LCM. It is nothing but least common multiple. What do you mean by least? You know very well about common multiple. What do you mean by least? Least is nothing but smallest. Okay, so the smallest common multiple is called least common multiple. So definition is over. Let us see the definition completely. The smallest number of the common multiples of two or more given numbers is called least common multiple of the given numbers. We know the definition of common multiple. We know the definition of multiple. Okay. After finding out the common multiples of given two or more numbers, we can easily find the smallest common multiple. That number is called least common multiple. Okay. Is it clear? Let us see some examples. Find the LCM of 4 and 6. For that, what do you mean by LCM? Least common multiple. For that, we have to find the multiples of 4 and 6 first. Then we have to find common multiples. Then we can find least common multiple. Okay. It is clear from the name itself. Okay. What we have to find first? We have to find first multiples. Then common multiples. Then least common multiple. Okay. What are the multiples of 4? We know very well. Multiples of 4 start with 4 and they are getting increased by 4. 4 plus 4, 8. Plus 4, 12. Plus 6. Sorry, plus 4, 16. Plus 4, 20 and so on. Multiples of 6. They start with 6 and increasing by 6. So 6 plus 6, 12. 12 plus 6, 18. 18 plus 6, 24. Plus 6, 30. Plus 6, 36 and so on. See, what are the common multiples? Now we have found multiples of 4 and 6. What are the common multiples of 4 and 6? Let us find out. 12 is a multiple of 4 and 12 is a multiple of 6. So the first common multiple of 4 and 6 is 12. We know very well that if 12 is the first common multiple and the second common multiple will be increased by 12. So 12 plus 12, 24. Let us check whether 24 is a multiple of 4 and 6. See, 24 is a multiple of 4. 24 is a multiple of 6. So, 24 is a common multiple. In that way, 24 plus 12, 36 is a multiple of 4. And 36 is a multiple of 6. See, in that way, common multiples start with 12 and they are increasing by 12. We know very well, we can find as many multiples as we want. There is no end to find multiples. Okay. So, you should not put a full stop. You should put and so on, etc. Okay. Now, we have found multiples of 4 and 6, common multiples of 4 and 6. Okay. What is the smallest number of common multiples? 12. So, the least common multiple of 4 and 6 is 12. Is it tough? No. Is it very easy? It's very easy to understand with an example. Now, look at the definition again. The smallest number of the given multiples of 2 or more given numbers is called least common multiple of the given numbers. Now, look here. LCM is nothing but least common multiple or lowest common multiple. Okay. Let us see some more examples. Find the LCM of 3 and 5. For that, find the multiples of 3 and 5. Then common multiples of 3 and 5. Then the least value of common multiples. Okay. So multiples of 3 start with 3 and they are getting increased by 3. Multiples of 5 start with 5 and they are getting increased by 5. What are the common multiples of 3 and 5? Let us see. Here 5 is the first number. Here 3 is the first number. We can see 15 is the common multiple. Very first common multiple. So we have written here. Since 15 is the common multiple, then it will be getting increased by 15 only. So 30 is the second common multiple. See, 30 is multiple of 3 and 5. So, this way, you can write as many common multiples as you need. Here I am going to find the least common multiple, so I have stopped with two common multiples. Don't forget, you should not put a full stop while finding multiples of any number. Okay, multiples can be found out indefinitely, so you should not put a full stop, you should put etc. marks. Okay, so LCM of 3 and 5 is the smallest common multiple 15. Okay, now this is easy. Find the LCM of 9 and 12. For that, first multiple of 9 and 12 should be found out, then common multiple of 9 and 12, then the least value of common multiples of 9 and 12. Multiples of 9 start with 9 by increasing by 9. Multiples of 12 start with 12 and they are getting increased by 12. Let us find out common multiples. 20, 18, 27, 36 is there. Yeah. Since 36 is the first common multiple of 9 and 12, then what will be the next one? 36 plus 36, 72. Yes. Let us check. Yeah, we got it. 72 is a multiple of 9 and 72 is multiple of 12 also. So, the second multiple, second common multiple is 72. Let us stop here and we can put etc. Okay. So, common multiples of 9 and 12 start with 36 and they are getting increased by 36. What is the smallest value of common multiples of 9 and 12? 36. Okay. So, LCM is equal to 36. Okay. Note, the first common multiple is called the LCM or lowest common multiple or least common multiple. Keep in mind, first common multiple, smallest common multiple, least common multiple, lowest common multiple are same only. Finding LCM by factorization method. In previous method, we found LCM by finding the multiples of each and every number and then by finding common multiples and then we found the smallest common multiple. But now we are going to know about the another method of finding LCM. This method is called factorization method. Find the LCM of 35 and 60. We know very well what you mean by factorization method. The process of expressing the given number as product of its factors is called factorization. Now, I am going to express 35 and 60 as its product of factors. Okay. Now, 35. You can write it as 1 into 35 or 35 into 1 or 5 into 7 or 7 into 5. I have written here 5 into 7. Okay. If you choose 35, then you should split 35 as 5 into 7. Okay. So, I have chosen 35 to be expressed as 5 into 7. Then 60, which is equal to 5 into 3 into 2 into 2. Okay. How did I found all those things? Like this. See? Since 35 ends with 5, it is divisible by 5 only. Or 3. Okay. But 35 is not a multiple of 3. So I chose 5. 35 divided by 5 gives you 7. So 35 is equal to 5 into 7. Similarly, 60 ends with 0, so it is divisible by 10 or 5 only. I choose 5. While dividing by 5, we get 12. 5 into 12 gives you 60. 12 is a multiple of 3 and it is also an even number. So, you can choose 2 or 3. I choose 3. 12 divided by 3 gives you 4. 4 is an even number. So, choose 2. 4 divided by 2 gives you 2. Okay. So, 60 can be written as either 5 into 3 into 4 or 5 into 3 into 2 into 2 also. Okay. However, the second way of expression will be useful in the next method, prime factorization. See, here the factors are prime numbers only. So you can write a 60 as 5 into 3 into 4 also, or 5 into 3 into 2 into 2 also. So what is LCM? Least common multiple is product of the factors. Common factors should be taken only once. Here 5 is the common factor of 3, 35 and 60. So you should write it only once. So 5 is written here. Next, in the first expression, 7 is left over. So 5 into 7, then into 3, into 2, into 2. Okay. So the product of this expression is the LCM of given two numbers. Okay. You can rewrite this in ascending form as 2 into 2 into 3 into 7 into 5, or 5 into 7, in 5 into 7. Okay. Now 2 into 2 gives you 4. Others are written as they are. Next, 2 into 2 is equal to 4. So 4 into 2 gives you 12. So 12 into 5 into 7. Now 12 into 5 is equal to 60. Into 7 is there as it is. 60 into 7, 7 into 0, 0, 7, 6 are 42, we have written here. So LCM of 35 and 60 is 420. Listen, least common multiple of any number is greater than the given two numbers. Least common multiple of two or more given numbers will be greater than two or more given numbers. Okay. In this case, 420 is greater than 35 and 60. Sometimes it will be equal to, you cannot, sometimes you may feel that multiple of any number is equal to or greater than the number, but we can keep in our memory that LCM is always greater than the given two numbers. Okay. Next example, find the LCM of 36 and 45. I am expressing 36 as 4 into 9, 45 as 5 into 9. I am not expressing 36 as a 2 into 2 into 3 into 3, or 5 into 3 into 3. Okay. So this is called factorization. In prime factorization, we should express each number in terms of prime numbers only. Okay. Now, LCM is nothing but product of its factors. So 4 is the smallest number, so I start with the 4. 4 into 5 into, we have 9 in both. So we have to take or write 9 only once. 4 into 5 into 9. 4 into 5 is 20. Then into 9 is there as it is. 20 into 9, 9 into 0, 0. 9 into 2, 18. So LCM is 19. Sorry, LCM of 36 and 45 is 180. Okay. Finding LCM by prime factorization method. Now, you know very well about finding LCM by factorization method. This is the extension of that method. We are going to find the LCM of 36 and 45. So, what is the difference between finding LCM of 36 and 45 using factorization and prime factorization? In this case, we have to express 36 and 45 in terms of its prime factors only. For that, let us start dividing 36 and 45 separately by prime numbers. 36 is an even number, so divide it by 2. What do you get? 18. 18 by 2 gives you 9. 9 by 3 gives you 3. 3 by 3 gives you 9. See, factors are nothing but divisors. Here, these values are the divisors. Till you get 1, you can divide the given number using prime numbers. Similarly, do the same process for 45. Since 45 ends with 5, I choose 5 to be the divisor. 45 by 5 gives you 9. We don't know the tables of division table of 45. Instead of that, I choose multiplication table of 5. In multiplication table of 5, I get 45 in 5 into 9. Okay. What about 9? This is a multiple of 1, 3 and 9. I choose 3 because 3 is the prime number and we are dealing with the prime factorization. 9 by 3 gives you 3. Then divide this 3 by 3 only. The quotient is 1. So 5 into 3 into 3 is the expression in terms of prime numbers. See, 36 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3, and 45 is equal to 5 into 3 into 3. Okay, so LCM, we know very well common multiples should be taken only once. Let us start from the first value, 2 into 2, then 3, 1 time 3, 2 time 3, then 5 is left over. Okay, so 2 into 2, 4, then 3 into 3, 9, so 4 into 9 into 5, 4 9s are 36 into 5, 36 into 5 is equal to 180. So, LCM of 36 and 45 is 180. Find the LCM of 66 and 110. Why do we find the LCM of these numbers by factorization? Because we don't know the multiplication table of 66 and 110. That's why we choose the method of factorization or method of prime factorization. Okay. Is it clear now? You can find LCM of given numbers for all the problems using multiples method also, common multiples method also. Since the given numbers are 2-digit numbers or 3-digit numbers, it is safe to factorize them instead of finding many multiples. Okay. Now 66. How to factorize 66 in terms of prime numbers? Let us see. 66 is an even number, so divide it by 3 or 2. 66 is a multiple of 3, so you can choose 3 also. But I have chosen 2. 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. Again, 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. 33 is an odd number or it is a multiple of 3. So, I choose 3 to divide 33. In 3 table, I get 33 11 times. So, 3 into 11 is equal to 33. For 11, this is a prime number. It can be written as 11 into 1 only. So, what are the factors? 2 into 3 into 11 is equal to 66. 110. It ends with 0. So, it can be divided by 5 or 0, 5 or 10. I choose 5 because 5 is the prime number. 1 by 5 is not possible. So, I choose 11. In 5th table, 5 2s are 10, balance 1. Then 1 and 0 gives you 10. So 5, again I am putting one more 2, 5 2s are 10. Okay, next, 22 is an even number. So I choose 2 as the divisor. 2 into 1 gives you 2, 2 into 1 gives you 2. 11 is a prime number. It is equal to 11 into 1. Okay. So, what are the factors? 5, 2 and 11. So, 110 can be written as product of its factors. Product of prime factors. 5 into 2 into 11. Or 5 into 2 into 11 into 1. Okay. Now, we have expressed the given two numbers as product of its prime factors. So, we can see 2 is common and 11 is also common. For 66 and 110. Okay. So, you have to write 2 only once. Then into 3. Then into 5. Into 11 only once. So 2 into 3 is equal to 6. 6 into 5 into 11. Now 6 into 5 is 30. What is left over into 11? See, 30 into 11 is nothing but 330. The calculation is here. Okay, LCM of 66 and 110 is 330. So you can find LCM of two or more numbers using common multiples method, factorization method, or prime factorization method. Okay. We have one more interesting method to find LCM, that is called short division method. Some are calling it as long division method or common division method, but this is short division method or shortcut method. Okay. Let us find out the LCM of 6, 4 and 8. We are given 3 numbers. We need to find the LCM of 3 numbers. So we choose shortcut method or short division method. So write down 6, 4 and 8 together. We are going to divide all these 3 numbers together by same number. Okay, listen carefully. 6 by 2. We have to divide 6 by 2. So 2 3s are 6. What about 4? 2 2s are 4. 8 by 2 is equal to 4. Okay, stop here. But 3 is an odd number. 2 and 4 are even numbers. 3 is a prime number, so it cannot be divided further except by 3 and 1. But we have 2 even numbers. So I choose number 2 to divide 2 and 4, but I cannot divide 3 by 2. So I write 3 as it is. Then I move to 2. 2 by 2 is 1. And 4 by 2 is 2. Okay. So, the LCM is nothing but 2 into 2 into 3 into 1 into 2. You can stop here itself. Okay. See, the second step, you have chosen 2 as the divisor, yet you couldn't divide 3 by 2. You are writing 3 as the quotient as it is. This is not quotient. You have nothing to do with 3 by 2. So you are writing 3 as it is. Okay. It doesn't mean 3 by 2 is equal to 3. You have to be very, very careful about this. Okay. So LCM is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 1 into 2, which is equal to 24. See, the common factor of 3 and 1 is 1. Common factor of 1 and 2 is 1. So we stop here. Find the LCM of 46 and 35. Both are multiples of 3. So I choose 3 because 36 is an even number and 45 is an odd number. So I cannot choose 2 to be divisor. So I choose 3 because 3 is dividing 36 and 45. So 36 by 3, I don't know. Okay, so I choose the multiplication table of 3. 3 into 12 will give you 36. What about 45? In third table, 15 times I am getting 45. Okay. Well, then 12 and 15. Again, they are multiples of 3. So, 3 into 4 is equal to 12. What about 15? 3 into 5 gives you 15. 4 and 5. Here, one is even number and another is odd number. So you can stop there itself. Okay. But since we have 4 as an even number, we have to choose 2 as a divisor to divide 4. So 2 into 2 gives you 4. We have nothing to do with 5 by 2. So write 5 as it is. Now common factor of 2 and 5 is 1. So you can stop here itself. You can stop here itself, nothing wrong. Okay. If you again choose 2, then you can divide 2 only, and you will get the answer 1. you have nothing to do with 5 by 2. So you have to write 5 as it is. Now 1 and 5. 5 is divisible by 5. So choose 5. 5 by 5 gives you 1. But 1 by 5 is not possible. So you write 1 as it is. So you can stop in this step itself. 2 and 5. Here the common factor of 2 and 5 is 1. Common factor of 4 and 5 is also 1. So you can stop here itself also. Okay, if you stop here, what should you do? 3 into 3 into 4 into 5 is equal to, is the LCM. Okay, so I have done here, see, LCM is equal to 3 into 3 into 4 into 5 or 3 into 3 into 2 into 2 into 5. Okay, if you are doing like this, what will you get? You will get 3 into 3 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 1 into 1. We don't need 1 into 1. Okay, you know the reason. Okay, any number multiplied by 1 will give you 1 only. Okay, so now let us do the calculation. 3 into 3 gives you 9. Then into 2 into 2 into 5 is there. Now 9 into 2 is equal to 18. We did nothing with the into 2 into 5. Now 18 into 2 into 5 gives you 36 into 5. 18 into 2 is 36. 36 into 5 is 180. So LCM of 36 and 44 is 180. We have two more examples here. Find the LCM of 42, 70 and 98. We use shortcut method because we are given three numbers. So we use shortcut method. 42 is even number. 70 and 98 are also even numbers. So 48 by 2 is 21. 70 by 2 is 35. 98 by 2 is 49. Now, 21 is a multiple of 3 and 7, 35 is multiple of 5 and 7, 49 is a multiple of 7. Okay, we are dealing with factorization, so it is better to choose prime numbers. So 21, 35 and 49 are multiples of 7, so we choose 7. So 7 3s are 21, 7 5s are 35, 7 7s are 49. So what is LCM? 2 into 7 into 3 into 5 into 7. See here, the common factor of 3 and 5 is 1. The common factor of 3 and 5 and 7 is 1. So it is enough to stop here. No need to proceed further till you get 1 1 1. Nothing is to be changed. So stop here itself. So, what is LCM? Just multiply all the numbers. 2 into 7 into 3 into 5 into 7. That's all. So, 2 into 7 is 14. 14 into 3 into 5 into 7. 14 into 3 is 42. 42 into 5 is 210. 210 into 7, 1470. So, LCM of 42, 70 and 98 is 1470. So, doing this long procedure is not necessary. You can stop here itself. You can stop here itself. Okay. Find the LCM of 54, 72 and 90 using shortcut method. Since the given numbers are even numbers, choose 2. 2 into 27 gives you 54. You can find it out using this normal division. Okay, 72 by 2 gives you 36. 90 by 2 gives you 45. Then 27, 36 and 45 all are multiples of 3. So 3 9s are 27. 3 12s are 36. 3 15s are 45. Next, 9, 12 and 15 are also multiples of 3. So I choose 3 as the divisor. 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15. Okay, now the common factor of 3 and 4 is 1. Common factor of 4 and 5 is 1. You can stop here itself. If you wish to express 4 as a product of prime numbers, you can choose 2 as the divisor. Yet, 2 is doing nothing with 3. So, 3 by 2 will not work. So, write 3 as it is. 5 by 2 will not work. So, 5 by 2. You have nothing to do. So, write 5 as it is. For 4, can be written, 4 can be written as 2 into 2. Stop here. 2 into 3 into 3 into 2 into 3 into 2 into 5. Okay. This is LCM of 54, 72 and 90. 1080 is the answer. So in this video we have learnt about definition of least common multiple, finding LCM using common multiples method, finding LCM by factorization method, finding LCM by prime factorization method, and finding LCM by shortcut method or short division method.